One can view the short diagonal case as follows. One can take even and odd planes in this consecutive intersection. So when you consider the only the intersection of even planes, then you get every the plane of roughly half dimension, which is generated by the even vertices here, and then the plane of also half dimension, which is generated by odd vertices, and this intersection will be the result of application of this short diagonal case. Let me come to that. So what are long diagonal pentagram maps? So for this, I will introduce yet one more notion, and it will be related with the choice of yet one more d minus one tuple. I would like to fix what's called an intersection d minus one tuple. Let me call this R. It will consist of the points, say, J1 and so on, JD minus 1. Now, what is this? Now I'll define a bigger class of pentagram maps that will be associated with both I and R. So with the choice of the diagonal, so I stands for the choice of the diagonal that and the vertices that we kind of use to define the diagonal. And now it will be related to this intersection tuple in the following way. So if I would like to find the image of a kth vertex, I take not consecutive intersections, but I take pk, but intersected with k plus j1. So actually, before j1 was just equal to 1, and j2 was equal to 1, and so on. So I just took the consecutive intersections. Now, I'll define which diagonal planes I intersect.
So I'm sorry. So you before define pki, then you define pkj plus minus. And they were
Let's forget for a while about this.
So you'll come back to
I'll come back to that in a second.
So this is PKI in the previous sense.
Yes. So so this is the intersection. And so the example that I just mentioned that before we considered that so these are the consecutive. So why it's kind of useful to consider these pentagram maps associated with the pair of d minus one tuple? And here is the theorem, Prof. Solovyov, is that, as a matter of fact, in this language, in a sense, these two tuples are dual to each other. In what sense? If I take the pentagram map associated with this pair of tuples, one of them is jump and the other is intersection, then it turns out that if I just interchange them, they are almost dual to each other. More precisely, I'll have to read them in the opposite order. So So it turns out that so here I is the tuple where I start with d minus 1 and go back to I 1. And similarly, r plus. So I just read them backwards. And it turns out that this, so in this way, by the way, in particular, we see that the pentagram map is actually an invertible system. So we can reconstruct the, so generically, each polygon is obtained, the map itself is obtained, one can construct the inverse of this map just by interchanging r and reading them backwards.
This identity is more like objective group.
Everything is on classes of projective equivalence, first of all. And second, it's just model the shift of indices, so I just
and
don't care about
projective.
It. And model, of course, model projective. This is always model projective. Example. So the original pentagram map on the plane has the jump tuple just two. We just jump one time by two vertices, and we took consecutive intersections, so it was 2-1. Of course, if I read them backwards, it will be just the same one tuple, so consecutive of one number only. So this is due to this map. So what does it mean if you remember the original pentagram map. So I just took. This polygon, which was spanned by the diagonals. What do I do here? I take, so I tuple is just one. So it means that I take this vertex and this one, and just I draw the corresponding diagonal plane. This diagonal, of course, coincides with the side of my polygon. But now I intersect them not consecutively, but every other one. So I intersect this one and this one. And then starting with the polygon here in Hilda, I get back the original polygon A. So this in particular so shows that indeed the original pentagram map was a bijection. Okay, now definition. So the long diagonal pentagram maps, or maybe first long diagonal planes. They correspond to I, which is M, M, and so on. So now we jump always by the same quantity, and the jump is equal to M. So in other words, so for this, I define the corresponding case plane to be Vk, Vk plus M, and so on, Vk plus M times D minus 1. And the long diagonal pentagram map is defined with this I, but R now is the encodes the information, so is the step sequence. Between two two M arithmetic sequences. For example. So let's take the set of integers, and I can have the M arithmetic sequence consisting of two pieces like that. So here, for instance, there will be several points, and everywhere the jump will be M. Then I'm just putting these two arithmetic sequences together on the same set of integers, and R will encode the jump.